Red.
That is horrifying.
Ready. When I got the audition through for the show, I was given two sets of sides. One was from Primal Fear, and the other set of sides was from Hellraiser. And then, like, second week of January, they're like, oh, Matt and Ross want to meet you. And I was like, oh my God, amazing. I didn't speak like throughout the whole meeting, which is quite unusual for me because I can be quite a chatterbox.
We've been talking about it since season one that we wanted a villain that could actually speak to our characters, that could sort of vocalize their motives and their thoughts, and also to get into our characters' heads.
It is time, man.
They just told me about the character and they kept on saying, oh, we love your voice, we love your voice. And I was thinking, what do you mean you love my voice? Like, it's just how I talk. And then at the end, they showed me what they were sort of designing the monster side of Henry as, or Beckner. And I just, like, my mouth fell to the floor. And I remember leaving the house and just, like, being like, that was so cool. That was so awesome. From what I knew of the character at that point, I'd already felt so invested. So when they were like, hey, you got it, I was like, oh my God, that was like a sigh of relief. It was like tears. It was a big deal. And then from there on in, I was put into the room with Barry Gower, and Barry and Duncan were designing Vecna.
So my name is Barry Gower, and I'm the prosthetics designer for Stranger Things Season 4. Vecna, it's a really fascinating character. He's humanoid, but we are basically integrating lots of shapes and textures and forms from the upside down. So there's a lot of kind of roots and vine, and we still have panels of flesh which are very pale, almost anemic looking. And the idea really is that the exposed flesh that is pale is human skin that hasn't seen sunlight for the last 20 years. Once we had a life cast of Jamie, basically we want all the appliances, rather than having a rubber monster suit, we were designing it as a kind of a jigsaw puzzle, which gives us a lot more fluid sort of movements. We don't have much buckling, and it's like we have a really skin tight sort of look.
Well, I'm in love. The first thing that I started to think about was the physicality of this person. I knew that we were gonna have these long fingers and just move my fingers around really slow. I'm moving them fast now because I'm excited, but move my fingers around very slowly, but then imagine them kind of being out here like this.
Matt and Ross were very clear that they wanted this large, distorted hand. When we started exploring the character and looking at the design of it, we were quite confident that we could do something practical by using mechanical finger extensions to extend Jamie's fingers 8 to 10 inches. So they are aluminium jointed finger extensions, and then it's a foam latex skin on the outside, which gives a quite a nice, smooth, organic sort of feel.
Now he's going to cry. Joy.
Yeah.
Thank you, dude.
Doing great.
There he goes.
Vecna is, chilling. Vecna understands us on a human level, and he understands us in our vulnerabilities and knows how to capitalize upon those to achieve exactly what he needs, and he will stop at nothing.
Mom, just loosening this up for you, sweetheart. You're going to look absolutely beautiful.
Vecna essentially is targeting people who are experiencing some kind of grief, or there's, you know, some troubles that are happening in their life, so they're emotionally vulnerable and fragile. I mean, it's the first time we've seen a threat that's so human. because you've had the Demogorgon and the Mind Flayer, but nothing quite like Vecna.
This is really the first time since season one that we're going back to the world of prosthetics, where we're actually having someone in a suit performing on the stage.
Selfishly, as an actor, it's so incredibly helpful because it's something real to look at, and especially just his demeanor on set and his performance and the amount of himself that he would bring after being in makeup for, I think, 8 hours every day, 2 hours to maybe take it off. That's like a full work day for somebody.
Being face to face with what is all practical effects, and that was all completely him, you feel so in the moment, which is, you know, such a, I felt like that was such a luxury. As put at ease to know that, like, I would actually have something to play off of, and someone as amazing as Jamie, who's just so talented.
Your time is almost at an end.
Let go!
The first time I saw Vecna, it was really, really surreal because I was going into a rehearsal right after lunch. And I'm very bubbly after, and you know, you're in your food coma. And I walked on and I saw him and he snapped his neck and looked at me.
And I'm there and I'm like fully in it, like staring at people, grunting, growling, like pacing.
And I looked at him and I was like, what is that? I didn't know. Like, I thought this was going to be CGI. Like, I didn't know.
She, bless her, she burst into tears.
The whole rehearsal, I was crying.
And she was like, that's not Jamie. And I'm crazy, so I was like, yeah, I was like talking to her inside my mind. I was like, no, Jamie's dead. Like, it's just dead. It's just Vecna.
It is over, Levin. Your friends have lost.
Jamie had to give me a hug because I couldn't do the scene. So the fear was genuine, definitely very real. I didn't have to act. I was terrified.
You know, Vecna is not some sort of sea creature from the deep. This character is not chaos. This character is very sure and uncertain and attentive to everything that he's doing.
I saw a means to realize my potential, to become the predator I was always born to be.
He felt like he was lied to, as well as kind of ostracized from his family, isolated, alone. Combine all these things together with the rage that he feels, and all of a sudden it's this sort of catalyst for terrifying events.
Tell her.
No!
Everything.
No!
When somebody is filled with so much rage and so much resentment, and he's been alone in that for a number of years, the human element's gone. He's now out for blood. He's now out for vengeance. Maybe we'll save that story for another day. It doesn't have a happy ending, I'm afraid. That's it?
That's it.
Beautiful. I always feel like these things are like a school test. Did I pass?